I like the exterior styling on this vehicle. It looks very European. The rear window really leans forward a lot, like the low-end Porsche and Audi products. There's little attention to details, as you can see in this light. It's very cute, it's very well finished, as is the rest of the exterior of this vehicle. It will appeal, I think, to buyers of Fiat and those who want a unique European styled vehicle, similar to those who buy Minis and things like that. It's interesting, my uncle owned one of these before, and well, he owned the Fiat 500, and I thought it was very small, though very cute. They made this one bigger. Everyone's making CUVs out of everything, so Fiat did the same thing too, so especially for the North American market, I should think. And you can see the optional wheels. This vehicle does have curves. Doesn't look like your typical SUV at all, at all, at all. However, when you open the trunk, there's quite enough room in here, I think, compared to its competitors, it's pretty decent. The trunk floor is pretty high, which means you won't break your back putting stuff in. Seats fold 60-40. The interior door design is pretty nice, reminiscent of the old Fiats. However, the interior space in back, I mean, I'm 5'9" and my head was brushing against the roof. My knees were brushing against the back of the seat and it wasn't that far back. It's kind of unacceptable to have this low back seat. You can see the monster panoramic roof. It's full of cubby spaces for the front driver. You can see the speaker there. The speaker grille is kind of interesting design. Just a note on the sound system, the optional sound system is excellent. As I have found out on all Dodge / Fiat / Jeep products, their optional sound systems are actually audiophile quality, well worth the options. In front, you have plenty of room, wide open, seats are comfortable, stylized even with the 500 there. A wonderful place to be, sitting in front of these Dodge products. These captain chairs keep you up, the elbow rest is at the perfect height, the ergonomics are impeccable, so easy to use. I could sit a 10-year-old in the car and they would instinctively know how to use all the different features, which is kind of amazing. These vehicles start at 23,000 and work their way up to 33,000. Depending on the equipment, of course, and the size of the wheels, etc. This vehicle in particular comes with the Tiger Shark engine, 2.4 liter naturally aspirated, which does 11 in the city, 8 on the highway. There is a smaller, I believe, 1.4 turbo, which does a bit better fuel economy. The chassis setup extremely soft, and compared to its competitors, well, I mean, you either love Fiat or you don't. So I have a difficulty thinking of competitors. Vibration harshness is subdued and it is noisy on the highway. All right, so like I'm sick like a dog, but it doesn't matter, we keep reviewing cars. So what about this Fiat 500X? It's kind of like Fiat's CUV, four-wheel drive. What about it? I'm on the highway now doing 105, which is about 65 US. It's a little windy. The suspension is very softly sprung. If you guys are thinking about Europe there when you're buying this vehicle, forget it. At least in terms of the ride, the chassis setup. It gets better though on the inside. The steering wheel is an extremely soft leather. So nice to grip this steering wheel. It's a nice steering wheel. And we have the familiar Jeep interior here. I'm not saying everything looks like Jeep. I'm just saying the layout, the ergonomics are very Jeep. You have speedometer that looks for you right in the face. You have a nicely positioned infotainment display here. You have wonderful control knobs for the temperature, the HVAC. You have a soft touch leather grip automatic transmission. You have a elbow rest, which is just at the right place of a cup holder. You have cubbies, you have soft touch material here. You have a very stylishly designed interior. It's very good from the inside. Now the car drives like a video game. There's absolutely no feel. You drive it with your fingertips and it's just the way it is. That's the disadvantage of a softly sprung vehicle. So it's certainly not, if you like driving, forget it. In the back seat, there's not a lot of room. My head brushes and I'm not that big. My knees too were very close to the seat back, and I put my seat quite forward. But that's where the bad news ends. You can fold the seats back 60-40, pretty easy. The visibility here, of course, is wonderful. There's a big fat A-pillar, but I mean, they all have big fat A-pillars, these trucks. Visibility is pretty good. I would say the exception is this rear view mirror is super small. It's way too small. However, the side rear view mirrors are very big, which is fine. Creature comforts. This vehicle comes with a heated steering wheel, which we love in Canada. It comes with heated seats. And it comes with an excellent sound system. I listened to it before with Ross, and it really sounded good. Really crystal clear. Great. Now, this soft suspension, it's way too soft. However, when you're driving on these shitty roads, I mean, you don't feel anything. It really feels comfortable. Ross made the remark, maybe they're looking out for the female clientele who doesn't like to be jarred. It's quite possible. And it's a good remark. All in all, it's a familiar story with these cars, with the, whether you have a Nissan Juke or whether you have like the Fiat or whether you have a Jeep. It appeals to the customers who inherently like these vehicles, who inherently like the exterior styling. However, the minimum quality is there, and overall, it's an okay experience, and it's an okay driving experience. Axton comfort, of course, but it's okay. Is this recommendable? Well, if you like Fiat, I think you could take it for a lease. Would I buy it? I don't know about Chrysler, Jeep, Fiat. I don't know about the reliability long term. I'm not so sure about that. I have to wait and see.